Namah Shivaya children. We will continue with the chapter HTML, Hypertext Markup Language. So today we will be learning a few more tags. The first tag that you can see over here is center tag or center element. Now center element is used to align the text or an image in the center of the web page. Whatever you are writing or if you are inserting any image in the web page, if you want to align that thing in the center, you can use the tag center. So basically that text and that image that you want to align in the center has to be put within the center tags. Center element is a container element, that's why you use the word within. That is, it has got a opening tag center and a closing tag backslash center. So the image or the text that you want to put as center has to be within the two tags, opening center and the backslash center. It will be clear to you as I show you in the as I write in the notepad and show you in the web page. So let us open the notepad for that. Open the notepad, just write HTML and close HTML. Within that, just type. I won't write much, I'll just write one sentence and show you how to align center. Write any sentence, say we are learning, we are learning center tag and close it with backslash center. So this particular line will be within the line that you have put within the center tag will be center aligned. Just save it properly. Save as. Select. You know already we used to save in the documents library. So in my documents, in the folder that I made, TNHTML practical. Over there I am saving it. All files. Just name the file name. I am just naming it as center only. Since we are learning center, so center is the page I am naming it. Center.html. Okay. Just save it. Now open the document center. You can see, so I prefer Google Chrome, I told you. So right click, open with Chrome. You can open with any browser, but Google Chrome is the one I prefer. So you can see that the web page is created. Since I just wrote one sentence, we are learning center tag, that particular line statement is center aligned. You can see it's in the center of the web page created. So this is the work of the center tag. And you can also see in the address bar center.html, that name is shown, and the entire address, the path of where I've saved it, that particular path is being shown in the URL, that is the address of the web page. So let us learn the next tag, horizontal rule, which is abbreviated by HR. Horizontal rule, as the name suggests, this tag is used to draw a horizontal line. Now it is generally used, suppose you want to break up one section of the document into two parts. Suppose the same web page, you want to divide into two parts, upper portion and lower portion. For that you can draw a horizontal line. Now it is an empty element, that is, it has got no closing tag, only one tag, HR. Another one empty element that we have learned earlier, if you remember, is the break tag, for giving BR tag, that is break tag, for giving one space. So it is no closing tag, it's an empty element, HR. And by default, the horizontal rule is shaded and engraved in 3D. We shall see it as we run in the as we see in the web page. You will understand what is the meaning of 3D and what is shaded. You will understand. Now horizontal rule is a tag, and it has got many attributes to describe the line that you are drawing. The first attribute is align attribute. Align attribute is used to set the alignment of the horizontal rule. The line that you are drawing, whether you want to align it in the left, right or center, accordingly you can use the attribute align and give the values according to how you want to do it, left, right or center, and you can align the particular line that you are drawing. Next attribute is width. Width is used to specify the width of the horizontal rule. Width means the size of the length of the horizontal rule, how much long it will be, or how much space of the web page the horizontal line will occupy. For doing that, you use the attribute width. Now you can write the value of width in number, absolute number, that's written, or in percentage or number of pixels also you can write. Percentage, if you write, percentage means how much percentage of the web page it is, the line is occupying. Like 80%, 70% of the web page, like that also you can say. Or you can give an absolute number like 200, 300, 500 for mentioning how much long the line would be. Then is size attribute. Size attribute is used to specify the thickness of the horizontal rule. How much thick the particular line that you want to draw will be. Next is no shade. It was told earlier that generally the horizontal rule that you are drawing, it is in 3D. That means the shade comes. But if you do not want any shade and if you want the line to be in 2D, then you can mention the attribute no shade. In that case, the line won't be shown in 3D, it will be shown in 2D only. And color attribute, the spelling please take care of, C-O-L-O-R. The color attribute is used to specify the color of the horizontal rule. Okay, whichever color of the line you want, blue, black, whichever, right? So that is what. So let us see in the notepad and just check how it is working. We'll be learning the HR attribute in the same page only that we just learned for center. So after center, you can give two breaks, BR, in order to give two spaces after the line center. So just two breaks I've used. Okay. After that, let us write HR tag. Okay. HR is a tag. Now the attribute first you've learned is align. Let us use that, align equals to center. Okay. Since center is the value of the attribute align, I hope you know what is the value. HR is the tag, align is the attribute, and center is the value for the attribute align. Similarly, another attribute that you've learned is width. So let the width, I told you can specify either in percentage or in pixels. Let us write in percentage only, say 80%. So 80% of the web page will be covered by the line that you are drawing. Then is size. Size is the thickness. So let us put the thickness, say 10. 10 is fine. But since these are numbers, we are not putting within quotes. The values we are not putting within quotes. This was a text, that's why we have put within quotes. So align, width and size are the attribute. After each of the attributes there are spaces. Might be you are not understanding, but after every tags and also after every attribute there are spaces. So HR space align, after that there is no space, equals to center. After center there is a space, width equals to 80%, space size equals to 10. Color and no shade we won't use now in order to describe you how the 3D line is drawn. Let's close it. Just save, normal save, because once we have saved as save as, open the browser, refresh it. I'm refreshing it. You can see the line is showing. You can see the line is shown in a 3D format. It is almost occupying 80% of the web page, of the screen. Or the page, however you can say, and a 3D kind of a thing is being shown. Since I wanted to show you in 3D, that's why I have not put in color, because if I would have put in color, the 3D effect that you can see, the depth that you can see over here wouldn't have been visible clearly. I will rather show you with a different size. If I increase the size, it will be more clear, the depth will be more clear. So I've just changed into 20. Save it. I could have done it Ctrl+S or just save. Refresh once more. The width has increased. Now probably you can see that there's a 3D kind of effect. The depth is kind of visible. So because of that, I did not use the color. If I would have used the color, it wouldn't have been visible. I'll show you the use of color and you understand then. After size, let us use the color. Say color equals to red. Now you will see the depth, that 3D effect wouldn't be visible. Just Control S. See, now the 3D effect is not visible. Because of that, the color I did not use earlier. So this is the color tag. This is how it works. And now let us get back to the notepad once more. Suppose I remove the color and I show you no shade. No shade means no 3D effect. Now see how the difference would be. Save it. Refresh. Can you see? There is no more 3D effect. But if I remove the no shade. Then again save and see. Refresh. You can see the 3D effect. So this is how the no shade works. But the only thing is, no shade you won't be able to, it doesn't work with the color attribute, because as you put the color, the shading of the 3D depth of the line is not visible. So this is what it is. Now width, I told you that you can write in percentage or in numbers. So let us show you in numbers and show how it works. Let us do it, say 550. A larger number of width you have to choose, otherwise it won't come as big. To save, yeah, it is still 550, smaller only. It has come, you know, it has, the line became smaller. So this is how the horizontal rule works, children. Now let us get back to the book once. So you can see, whenever you use the align attribute in HR tag, it is necessary to use the width attribute along with it. Naturally, width attribute, if you do not write it, the width, if you don't specify the length of the line, naturally the line won't be effective. Then when the color, and this is very important, like I was saying, when the color and no shade attributes are used together in a web page, the color attribute makes the no shade attribute ineffective. So very important part is this, then color and no shade attributes doesn't work together. The color attribute makes the no shade attribute ineffective. So that is why I showed you after after writing the code in the notepad, that how after removing the color attribute, the shading and no shading was visible. Okay, children. So wherever in the book I have highlighted, you all will underline it. You all see the codes that I have learned. This is the code that I've showed you. Sorry, this code, you can write the code, the center and HR code both in the copy, and the output you can write. The output that has come this way, we are learning center tag, it has come in the center, and the line has come in the center as well. So this is the code and the output that you have to do. Code, of course, in the rule page, and output in the white page. Okay, children, and underline the things that I have highlighted in the book. Next day we will proceed with other tags. Namaskar.